Just 90 minutes south of Tokyo lies a picturesque town named Hakone. This town is known for its stunning views of Mount Fuji, natural beauty, hot springs, open-air museum, and many more. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can plan your day trip to Hakone from Tokyo. So do watch this video till the end. Now let us first talk about transportation. The Hakone Free Pass gives you unlimited rides on 8 modes of transportation in Hakone and one round trip regular ticket on Odakyu line, that is from Shinjuku to Odawara station. Additionally, it provides discounts on some of the attractions in Hakone area such as the Hakone Open Air Museum. The pass can be purchased at ticket counters, ticket machines at Shinjuku stations or online in the digital form on your smartphone. Do check description for more details. Apart from Odakyu line regular trains that runs from Shinjuku station to Odawara station, there is a limited express romance car train that drops you directly at the Hakone Yumoto station, which is the entrance of Hakone. To ride this amazing train, you just need to pay the limited express surcharge either online or offline at the Shinjuku station. Keep in mind, you need both Hakone Free Pass and a limited express ticket to ride this train. So here is the plan. I am going to take the romance car train from Shinjuku station to Hakone Yumoto station and then explore the Hakone area in a clockwise direction by making use of bus, ship, ropeway, cable car and train. So I'm all set with my digital Hakone free pass and a limited express romance car ticket. And now it's time to board the train. Well, after taking a scenic train journey, now it's time to take a bus to reach my first stop, which is Amazake Chaya. The Amazake Chaya is a historic tea house known for its traditional atmosphere and delicious offerings. Established 400 years ago during the Edo period, this charming establishment has been serving travelers and locals with its signature Amazake, a sweet non-alcoholic beverage made from fermented rice. Amazake is naturally sweet because of the sugar in the rice and you can have it hot or cold. Wow, that tea was quite amazing. And now I am fully recharged to move ahead in my journey. I took another bus from Amazake Chaya to reach the lakeside town named Moto Hakone. This is Lake Ashi, and from here you can see the view of Mount Fuji on a clear day. Can you see that red torii gate? That's where I'm heading next, so come with me. As you walk along the shores of Lake Ashi, you will reach Hakone Jinja Shrine. This shrine is hidden inside the dense forest, but you can easily find it as there are huge standing torii gates with one standing prominently in the lake. A series of steps from the torii gates leads to the main shrine building. After visiting the shrine, it's time to head back to Lake Ashi, where I'm going to hop on a pirate ship which would take me from one end of the lake to the other. One to two ships leave every hour and it will take you across the lake in 30 minutes. This pirate ship cruise is fully covered in Hakone Free Pass. From here, I am going to take a ropeway to reach Owakudani, which is an active volcano area on the slopes of Mount Hakone. The last eruption occurred roughly around 3,000 years ago. Today, in this area, you can experience the distinctive smell of sulfur and witness the steam rising from the ground. And on a clear day, you can see the panoramic view of Mount Fuji. Owakudani is also one of the major sources of hot spring water, which are piped to various hot spring facilities.
In these various hot spring pools, eggs are cooked until their shells turn black due to sulfur. And it is believed that eating one of these eggs can extend your life by 7 years.
Additionally, you can also try black soft serve ice cream made from bamboo charcoal. A ropeway and a cable car to reach the next stop, Hakone Open Air Museum. Hakone Open Air Museum is a renowned art museum that seamlessly blends nature and art. It features an extensive collection of modern and contemporary sculptures beautifully integrated into the landscaped gardens and surrounded by stunning mountain views. A must-visit spot is the Picasso Pavilion, which houses an impressive collection of over 300 works by Pablo Picasso, including paintings, sculptures, ceramics, and sketches. The final stop in the Hakone region is Hakone Yuryo, one of the several hot spring facilities in the area open only for day trip visitors. You can also visit this place by taking a free shuttle bus from Hakone Yumoto Station. Unfortunately, we couldn't go there due to time constraint, but I would definitely recommend you to visit this place. You can see the description for more details. I returned back to Tokyo by using Odakyu Line regular trains. Keep in mind that Hakone Pass do not cover limited express trains. Well, I really enjoyed this day trip to Hakone and I hope you have enjoyed it too. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And please do like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And don't forget to hit the bell icon.